Real quick look today at another Funko Pop from Invincible, the epic and so highly recommended comic and Amazon TV show. Definitely check it out if you've not seen it. It is not for a younger audience, but it is one hell of a story. I've already reviewed in the past the Diamond Select Omni-Man figure there, and I'm hoping the McFarlane Toys at one point bring out a Mortal Kombat version, so looking forward to the action figure versions of him. But this today is all about Funko Pop and their new line of Invincible Pop. There's quite a few different versions of these. We have a Mark, Adam Eve, and Omni-Man, and there are both bloody versions of Mark and Omni-Man. I'm not quite sure about Adam Eve. I think she might have a variant as well out there. And there is another version of both Omni-Man and Invincible Man in a kind of diorama piece, which is really all about this phrase. And if you know the show, you'll know what we mean there. So nice little touch by Funko that it was inside the flap on the box. Always about the flaps. And a nice little inclusion there, for fans that know what we're talking about. So again, Omni-Man on the side of the box, number 1500, rather auspicious in the Funko Pop line. And again, not much else to show you other than the Omni-Man kind of Funko Pop rendition on the side of the box. And again on the back. And if you want to look at the UPC, etc., it is there. The UPC for the non-bloody version of Omni-Man. Right, so let's get a quick look at this pop. It comes with a really excellent dynamic stand, so we've got a really good clear Perspex stand that the figure is glued into just above his butt, but it helps to really add the flying aspect to the figure. Look, again, it's a Funko Pop, so you know that the situation by now. We've obviously got the super deformed head, but they've certainly captured the look and feel of the figure really well. They've got the Omni-Man Tash. Just that killer tash that he's got there, voiced by the incredible J.K. Simmons in the show. But it's a nice balance. The bloody variant is exactly the same, but just with blood splatter across it. What we do get, it seems here, is different molded parts of the red and the white. It's a little bit more grey here than it is in the actual comic and show, with the Diamond Select one being a little bit more white, off-white. So this one's a little bit darker here. But the cape looks great too, flying away in the background there, looking very good. He's looking very grey, like me, these days. But it's a great little figure. The only downside is the head is a little downwards. It's a little pointed downwards. So when I put this down flat, you'll see it kind of just looks a little sad and a little down the way. So it's a little angled down the way, whereas this would have been a little better had that been kind of moved up a bit. So your poses could vary, you could have them like so and so, but you can see how he's leaning forward just a little too much. So yeah, it's a small niggle, but it is a niggle that it's just a kind of drooping Omni-Man as such. It's not the best I think they could have done. Helps if you pose it a little bit more to the right and so forth, but there you go. There's next to one of my favourite all-time Funko Pops, just to give you some variety in size and scale. And obviously it's Funko, so there's a Deadpool next to the figure there, Marvel Legends. Give you a rough idea of what's going on there. So, again, that's it. Omni-Man, the only articulation, I should say, is on the head, so that rotates. And that is it for him. Nice little figure. Look, again, it's not for everybody, but just giving it a quick review and a look at, just so you can see some of the small issues and flaws in this one. But if you like Invincible, highly recommend if you've not watched it, go and watch it and read it. It is a mind bender. But that's it from me and Omni-Man. We will see you for more figure reviews coming right up.